Click on the subscribe button to subscribe to our channel. Press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.
Good evening to all. Still discussing the paper? Yes? It was such kind of a paper that needs discussion, right? Kaisa laga tha? How was the paper to you? Huh? Vague questions. Tukke wale questions. Yes. Questions were not even easy. Questions seemed easy. Yes. Themes were... themes looked like, yes, I can do it. But the options were too close. Too close, yes. And then, what else? How many completed the paper? Completed the paper. How many had the situation that they attempted 50, 60 questions and then they had just 30, 40 minutes? How many felt ki iske liye pad jate to bhi nahi hota? Yes? So this paper didn't require any kind of preparation except few questions. Except few standard questions which came from probably NCRT. And how many left ancient medieval despite of me telling you at least three topics kar lena? Mughals, Vijayanagar, Bhakti Sufi. So you completely left. Now you cannot leave anything, yes? Yes or no? Okay. So jokes aside, this paper was tough. Tough because of the options given. Tough because of probably you don't get those themes or statements in readable sources which you commonly read. Tough because it was lengthy, right? Yet, you still had chances to minimize your mistakes. You still could apply a certain kind of elimination and there were questions which could be solved through elimination. But hota kya hai na, you know, it's very easy to say right now that you can eliminate. I can understand that probably in the examination condition, you don't really get those clues. So that's why it's very, very important, as we all say, that you have to be very calm and cool. UPSC paper will be like this. They will give you shock, right? And they are checking you ki kaun masti mein kar raha hai. And you have to be cool. You have to be cool about it. Cool in the sense not doing the hard work, but with respect to hoga to hoga, nahi hoga to nahi hoga types. Right? You don't have to take that kind of load. Because when you take the load, the worse happens. Even then worse happens. And when you are doing your hard work, then also there is no guarantee. Yes? So that is how the paper was. Okay, so I will be taking history and polity questions, and with respect to respective sections, if you have any doubts, you have any reservations with whatever the answers are given, you can discuss with the faculties. So let's start the discussion. So with respect to history, there were 16 questions, right? A huge number again. And mind you, again, the static was emphasized in the paper. It wasn't that static was not emphasized. Current affairs was not conventional current affairs. Very practical governance aspect of current affairs was asked, right? When you talk about environment, there were environmental governance questions. When you talk about economics, you have leases, mining, all those things, right? So there were very practical governance aspect questions, yet you were having certain static portions. So let's come to history section. So this year, with respect to medieval Indian history, there were 5 questions. Modern Indian history, 6 questions. Ancient Indian history, 3 questions. Art and culture, 2. Bahut tension li art and culture ki. Right? The easiest question on Buddha, on Mahayana Buddhism. Dekho, tension lene se kuch nahi hota, that's what I say. Masti mein karo, paper. Okay, modern Indian history questions. Charter Act of 1813. A static portion. Why medium difficulty? Because the second and the third options, you don't read it with such clarity. That's why we've kept it in medium. Otherwise, you can classify it as medium and difficult both. But because of the expectation level of this topic, we always say that acts are asked. And every year it is the case that acts are asked. So if whatever topics which UPSC asks you on regular basis, you have to do it in a deep way. Right? That is what my take is on history. So the first statement, it ended the trade monopoly of the East India Company in India except for trade in tea and trade with China. This is true. Even second is true. Third is incorrect. Incorrect. Right? Second, it asserted the sovereignty of the British Crown over the Indian territories held by the company. This is true. Third is incorrect. So answer is 1 and 2 only. Coming to Swadeshi question, very easy question. But I have heard that many students got this question also wrong. How many did this question as wrong? Paid emphasis on whether it was established or not. Why? Yeah, spectrum mein itna acha se diya hua hai. Kya? Nahi, nahi, ye sahi hai. This is true. Right? Coming to Swadeshi movement, 2 was explicitly given even in spectrum. Yes? There were 3 resolutions passed, Swadeshi boycott and national education. And 2 is correct. If you happen to see it from spectrum, you'll get the answer. Okay. It contributed to the revival of the indigenous artisan crafts and industries. Second, the National Council of Education was established as a part of Swadeshi movement. The test series questions were also on these lines. So probably now you don't have any doubt with respect to the second question. Okay. So we had asked this question, establishment of National Council of Education, that was directly which was asked in UPSC paper. Right? Okay. Coming to this question. Organizations, acts, organizations and their leaders is what again UPSC has been asking in the last 2-3 years, right? And whatever movements or organizations they have given, again, was not that difficult. You've been seeing these things in your test series questions, right? All India Anti-Untouchability League, yes, it's Mahatma Gandhi. All India Kisan Sabha, yes, it's Swami Sahajanand. Self-respect movement, Periyar, Ramaswamy Naikar. So it's an easy question. 1, 2 and 3 is the answer. Okay, fine. Coming to this question. Now, this question is there in NCRT. Okay. But then also, you can apply certain kind of logic. Now, how many mark this question as A? Logic lagaya tha? What? Yes, exactly, exactly. So if you see the options, cotton, wheat, cotton, these are all indigenous crops. Although the context is not America and Europe and not India, but Europe and America with respect to New World and Old World crops. But even if you apply and consider Old World as India, you still could have arrived at the answer. But this is again by fluke. Right? Logical elimination. That's it. So, A is the answer. Coming to this question. Again, this Mahatma Gandhi question. Mahatma Gandhi, every year you get this question. Yes? Get a question from Mahatma Gandhi. First statement kya hai? Endangered labor, Peter Maritzburg railway incident, South African experiments. So one is correct. Now see the options again. Second, in Lord Chelmsford war conference, Mahatma Gandhi did not support the resolution on recruiting Indians for World War. Now what World War the statement is talking about? Which one? First, in the First World War, the moderates supported the British. That's it. So the answer is B, 1 and 3. ठीक है? Fine. ये भी बताया था. Options देख लिया करो थोड़े से. Right? चलो. I can understand. person and position held. Now, this question again is medium difficulty. Why? Because you don't specifically read about KC Neogi or Tej Bahadur Sapru, right? But yet the source is very direct. You get the personality names, the organization names from Spectrum or any other history guide which you buy, right? So that is why the answer is medium and the answer is 1, 2 and 3 again. Okay? Now coming to medieval Indian history section. What were the themes asked by UPSC in medieval Indian history? Mughals, Bhakti Sufi, Vijayanagar. Yehi teen boli hai karne ko. Right? Coming to this question, we are Tansen. Although the answer is Tansen was the title given to him by Emperor Akbar is not correct. The title which was given as Tansen was provided by the King of Gwalior. Now, to your surprise, this question is from the Hindu, right? There was this article which you get on Friday with respect to culture, right? You get certain pages in culture on Friday, entertainment page. So from there, this question was picked up line by line. Tansen was the title given to him by Raja Vikramjit of Gwalior. Tansen was a court musician of the Darbar of Raja Ramchandra of Bandhavgarh. When Akbar heard of his prodigious talent, he sent a farman, he invited him, and then he made one of the Navratnas in his court. And he gave the title as Mia. Theek hai? Drupad ke baare mein bhi likha hai. It is talking about the ragas also. It is also talking about that he also composed songs on his patrons. Right? So this question is directly made from you. Directly. Theek hai? My again take on this will be three sections from medieval Indian history. Mughals, Vijayanagar and your Bhakti Sufi. They are very very important. UPSC go deep in them. But when you come across any editorial, any write-up, either in Indian Express or the Hindu, please make a note of it. Because the theme is very important, right? Because otherwise you don't get these kind of information in one book. For that, I may not recommend you the optional textbooks, right? And it's not feasible also. UPSC doesn't want you to read very high-end books for every subject. They just want you to have, you know, general awareness information about certain themes. That's it. Okay? Coming to next question. Who among the following Mughal emperors shifted emphasis from illustrated manuscripts to album and individual portrait? Right? The answer is Jahangir. And again, the NCRT says so. So the NCRT is saying Mughal painting reached climax under Jahangir, who had a very discriminating eye. It was a fashion in the Mughal school for the faces, bodies and feet of the people in a single picture to be painted by different artists. He also claimed that he could distinguish the work of each artist in a picture. Apart from painting, hunting, battle and court scenes, special progress was made in portrait painting. Now coming back to the question. Question is asking you, who among the following shifted the emphasis from manuscripts, illustrated manuscripts, to album and individual portrait? So it started from Jahangir. However, Shahjahan predominantly used portrait painting. But the question is asking you, who shifted the emphasis, right? And even your CCRT website say so. You have a topic on painting, you can get and verify the answer from there. But the answer is Jahangir, right? Okay, coming to the next question, again Mughals, Jagirdar and Zamindar. Now who were Jagirdars? How was the, have you heard about Mansabdars? So Mansabdars was a political administrative rank, right? And those Mansabdars who were given salary in terms of land or Jagir, they were known as Jagirdars. But Jagirdars are definitely holders or land assignments, but in lieu of judicial and police duties is what UPSC has trapped you in. It was only police and military duties, but not judicial duties, right? So this is Wrong. Even the land assignments, the second statement, the land assignments to Jagirdars were hereditary and revenue rights or Zamindars were not hereditary. It is wrong. Zamindars again were the local chieftains, right? And they were hereditary. So again, this statement is wrong. So the answer is D. Okay? And then you can read, again the source for this is not completely NCRT, but you can develop an understanding on Mansabdars and Jagirdars from your NCRT textbook, Themes in Indian History Part 2. Okay? Zapt and Zamindars, then you have Mansabdars, right? You have your old NCRT also, Satish Chandra, where there is a mention of Jagirdars and Zamindars, right? Okay, coming to next question. Again, this question is somewhat, again, you can eliminate few things. So you must have heard about Ikta system. The second statement says Ikta system of Sultans of Delhi was an ancient indigenous system. This is wrong. It was not ancient indigenous system. So you get two statement as wrong. When you talk about the office of Mir Bakshi, it was again in Mughals, not Khaljis. So third is also wrong. So the answer is one only, that in the revenue administration of Delhi Sultanate, the in charge of revenue collection was known as Amil. Right? Coming to Bhakti Sufi. I agree that this is a difficult question, but if I tell you that you have partial information in your NCRT and partial information in the test series, then you should not have done this question wrong. Why? Saint Nimbark was a contemporary of Akbar. We had given one question on Ramanujacharya where we had asked Acharya Nimbark and Madhava were contemporaries to him. So if Acharya Nimbark is contemporary to Ramanujacharya, his time period is 11th century, right? And Akbar's time period is 16th century. Okay, so first galat ho jata hai. Now coming to the second statement, Saint Kabir was greatly influenced by Sheikh Ahmed Sirhindi. You go to NCRT, there is a timeline given, and 1600 to 1700, what is written? Sheikh Ahmed Sirhindi in Haryana. And what is Kabir's period? Upar. Right? 1400 to 1500. So that is how UPSC is giving you questions. Contemporary they had given you last year also, Annamacharya and Ramanujacharya, right? So I am not saying that there is a pattern, but yes, there is a pattern in the themes at least. Bhakti Sufi hai, to Bhakti Sufi poochenge. Mughals are important, they will ask Mughals. But how deep they go, you just cannot preempt, right? That is what is the take. Now coming to art and culture questions, very few questions, right? I was happy because you know whenever you all say art and culture, kya hi pooch lete hai? And I was very happy that I could only see two questions, but then I was disappointed also to see the kind of statements they had given in the paper. Okay, Mahayana Buddhism, very easy question. Deification of the Buddha, trading the path of Bodhisattvas, image worship and rituals, they are all part of Mahayana Buddhism. So 1, 2 and 3 is the answer. How many got confused in deification of Buddha? Hindi padlo. No, it's very very important to even read in Hindi if you get stuck in some English word, right? So if you could read it, you could have got the understanding. So 1, 2 and 3 is the answer. Okay? Okay. Coming to building Kalyan Mandaps. देखो ये मेरा एक ऑब्जर्वेशन है, डोंट टेक इट अदरवाइज. विजयनगर इज अ वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट डायनेस्टी एंड वेन एवर विजयनगर इज मैंशनड, आंसर इज दिस. ठीक है, नॉट इन विजन टेस्ट सीरीज बट इन यूपीएससी, राइट? सो विजयनगर इज द आंसर एंड आई ऑलवेज एम्फसाइज दिस. पिक्चर्स देख लो एनसीईआरटी में, कल्याण मंडप एनसीईआरटी पिक्चर. That's it. Khatam tha ye question. So they are making questions from the observation. They are not asking you questions from, lines. General observation. that do you know Kalyan Mandap or Mandaps or Gopurams were important features of Mujinagar dynasty or not? Right? So please don't ignore such things. So if you're coming here to have the analysis and the take on what to do next, this is how, and that is how you can do it. Right? You have to be very open. Open in terms of even your thinking that what could be asked and what not could be asked. You should not have biases that, okay, I will not do ancient medieval, I will not do culture. You have to do it. But you don't have to go to deeper books, periphery, standard textbooks. That is, and the rest, the test series can take care of that, right? Because you can't read each and every book. It's just impossible, just impossible. And you just cannot predict what UPSC will ask, right? So that is how it is. Coming to polity and governance questions. So 12 questions is what polity and governance area was having. And trust me, not apart from one or two questions, no Lakshmikant kind of questions, yes? So that also made the paper difficult. Okay? Okay. So coming to the first question, social capital. You don't get this in textbooks, but yes, when you read sociology, you read sociology NCRT, you read editorials in the newspaper where social capital is emphasized, you then kind of understand what is social capital. So whenever terms are given in terms of context of governance, polity, please make a note of it. At least you should clear your concepts. So social capital is the level of mutual trust and harmony which should be seen in the society, right? That is what is social capital. Coming to the governor question, directly from Lakshmikant, right? So when you read the recommendations which no one reads for prelims, they've asked that question, right? So the recommendations are part of mains preparation. Ki ye recommendation kisne di hai, theek hai? Although the recommendation given here is that the governor should be an eminent person from outside the state and should be a detached figure without intense political links or should not have taken part in politics in the recent past, has been given by Sarkaria Commission, and that is what you get in Lakshmikant as one of the recommendations when you read Sarkaria Commission, that he should be a detached figure and not too intimately connected with the local politics of the states. Directly from Lakshmikant, but yet very, very difficult. Reason being, you don't read it, right? Especially for prelims. Okay. Coming to this question, difficult yet doable if you apply logic. Okay. I think everyone is clear about Finance Commission's role and mandate, right? So you read on the principles of finance, on the basis of which they give grants to states and center, right? So they don't have this function of reviewing the regulators in different sectors. You eliminate three, there are two options left. What you have to see? Five. Niti Aayog, again, does not have any mandate like this. You cut five, you get the answer. Now this question again, it's not as if you will now dig on the regulators and read and complete every regulator for prelims, but UPSC is giving you certain logical eliminatable questions, right? Don't get disheartened by seeing such things. You have to learn, and you have to learn it that way, the way UPSC is giving you the questions, because ultimately it's your decision to sit for this exam, and you have to do it the way it requires you to prepare. Right? So you will be getting certain logical questions, you will be getting certain factual questions, you will be getting certain deeper conceptual questions, and that is how the mix of questions will be. Okay? It's your luck if question papers come easy, but then you have to be prepared for the worst, the difficult. Right? Okay. Coming to the next question, with reference to the Constitution of India, consider the following statements. No High Court shall have the jurisdiction to declare any central law to be constitutionally invalid. An amendment to the Constitution of India cannot be called into question by the Supreme Court. Now, when you read certain judgments, when you read newspapers, you get certain kind of understanding of polity. Now, this is what, again, this question is checking you. It's not expecting you to learn each article, but to again rethink. Kya any amendment to the question of India cannot be called into question by Supreme Court? It can be. It can be called into question by Supreme Court. So, the two is wrong. What about first? No high court shall have the jurisdiction to declare any central law to be constitutionally invalid. It can, right? So the answer is neither one nor two, right? So 42nd Constitutional Amendment Act inserted new article, which was 228A, and that provided this provision, and it was Keshanand Bharti case which provided the second statement explanation. Coming to the controversial question, right? Liberty. Ab ye bhi Lakshmikant se. This question is also from Lakshmikant, but they've given you all. I'll just show you the snapshot. Now the question is, so the question is having keywords like in the context of polity. The question is asking you, would you accept? The question is asking you appropriate definition, right? So there are three keywords in the context of polity. What would you find the most appropriate definition of liberty? Now what is Lakshmikant saying? Liberty means the absence of restraints on the activities of the individuals. But at the same time, it is providing opportunities for the development of individual personalities. However, liberty does not give license to do what one likes and has to be enjoyed within the limitations mentioned in the Constitution itself. In brief, the liberties conceived by the preamble of fundamental rights is not absolute, but qualified. Now coming to the question again. See the options. Absence of restraint is mentioned in the definition. Opportunity to do whatever one likes is excluded, that it does not give you the license to do whatever you like. But opportunity to develop oneself fully is also part of the definition, right? But because of the qualifiers like these, polity, now there are two concepts, negative and positive liberty. Yes, absolutely, negative liberty is absence of restraint, but not absence of all restraints, right? I don't know how far the word or this term will be used by UPSC, but negative liberty means this, and positive liberty enables you to develop and give you opportunity to develop fully. Now coming to the polity context. Now the only interpretation of personal liberty is found mentioned in which of the article explicitly? Article 21, right? Personal liberty. Now what is the implementation part of Article 21 through the amendment? Article 21A, right? Article 21A. Now what is Article 21A providing to you? Elementary education, right to education. And what is education providing to you? Opportunity to develop oneself fully. So in the context of polity, the appropriate answer is this, right? This is also definition, this is also definition, but because of appropriate definition and in the context of polity, we have only example of Article 21A and 21, which is providing you the opportunity to develop, right? So the answer is D, right? But UPSC is the, will be having the real answer keys. Okay? Okay, coming to this question. See, we can always go by logics and rational reasoning. That is what I'm providing you, or we are providing you, right? Okay, coming to this question. Now this question also, why this is considered as difficult? Because of the length of the words. So this is a very long question, right? But it's made cheesy thi bas, simple. Again, I understand the logics don't work in examination, but if you know the brackets of the articles or the constitutional provisions, you understand that election commission is which article? 320s, right? What is C, financial crisis? What is D? So parliament and state legislatures are where? 70s and 160s, right? Right? 169 kya hai? Abolition and creation of legislative councils, right? And Supreme Court's article is 140, 142, 141, 136. So this was the only option, close, if you go by such kind of logics. But these will only come when you are Buddha. Right? You attained Nirvana and nothing impacts you. Right? And you are in that enlightened mode. Right? So that is how you can attempt this question. Aapko kya karna hai? You have to get prepared for such kind of logics and tricks. That is what I'm telling you. Right? You have to open up your brain. Because you won't leave this question. No one would have left the question. Very few people would have left this question. And the paper was also like this. That it was tempting you to attempt. Right? So that is how few questions could have been done with logic. So the answer is B. Coming to this question. With reference to the Legislative Assembly of a state in India, consider the following statements. Now this question is tough. Tough being you must not have ever heard about the second statement. Right? First statement sabko pata hogi that it is true. But the second statement is saying when a state legislature does not have a rule on a particular matter, it follows the Lok Sabha rule on that matter, which is wrong. And now this statement has been picked up directly from the Constitution, Article 208, which is telling which is providing the state legislature for to make their own rules. In case there are no rules, the speaker will be consulted. But there is no mention of that if there is no rule for the state legislature, they may follow Lok Sabha rule. So that is directly from the constitutional provision. Now again the question would be, do we have to do each and every constitutional provision? The answer will be no. No. You cannot do everything. You had to leave this question. Because it was a two-statement question and it was not giving you any opportunity to eliminate anything. Right? Okay. Coming to this, again a debatable question. So there are two cases. One is, answer is one only. Answer to this question is one only. Right? Now which article of the Constitution of India safeguards one's right to marry the person of one's choice? UPSC had crossed its limits in this question. It has definitely. I don't know how far people will now read the judgments. Now, I agree that the judgments which they are asking, they are having an impact on very important articles. Only for that reason this question is justified. But then there are back-to-back cases, recent judgments on this. I don't know how many of you must have come across Hadia case. Now Hadia case is the recent one and it explicitly says that the right to marry the person of one's choice is Article 21. In the previous case it was both Article 19 and 21. Right? Agar ko ye logic lagayega that I have to see the broader perspective, then also you should mark 21, but the correct answer is 21 only. Right? So answer is B. Okay. Coming to the next question. The 44th Amendment to the Constitution of India introduced an article placing the election of the Prime Minister beyond judicial review. No. Now again, this question is somewhat relevant. Reason being, there are certain amendments. And the recent amendments, right? Then there is 73rd Amendment, 74th Amendment. These are very important amendments. At least you should every month go through them. Don't rectify it by heart, but go through them. Then only they will be internalized. Okay? So first is wrong. It was not 44th, but 39th Amendment. The second statement is saying the Supreme Court of India struck down the 99th Amendment to the Constitution of India as being violative of the independence of judiciary. This was very much in news. So second is correct. But question why this is still difficult because of the 99th Amendment. Probably you must not be having this memory of recollecting that what was 99th Amendment all about. Right? So second is correct. So the answer is two only. Coming to the next question. Kitna bada question hai. Now that is what UPSC has done with this paper. They had intimidated you, right? You were not expecting four statements in a question, you were not expecting five options in a question, and this has naturally changed the mind of the candidates automatically. But the question again is easy and doable. So the third statement, what is it saying? The details of the process of impeachment of the judges of Supreme Court in India are given in the Judges Inquiry Act, which is true. What about the second one? The Constitution of India defines and gives details of what constitutes incapacity. It is wrong. So two is eliminated. What is fourth saying? Special majority, which is correct. What is first saying? The motion to impeach a judge of the Supreme Court of India cannot be rejected by the Speaker of the Lok Sabha as per the Judges Inquiry Act, which is again wrong. So the answer is 3 and 4 to this question. Although a straightforward question, but because of the wordy statements, it was done wrong by the candidates, despite of probably even knowing about it, right? कहाँ लिखा है ये? Then house होता है, वो then के लिए होता है, that के लिए नहीं होता। Then members, effective majority is then members. No. ठीक है? So its answer is 3 and 4 only. 9th schedule, easy one. First Amendment Act 1951. 1951, Jawaharlal Nehru, right? But again, that required memory that it was First Amendment Act 1951, right? So Jawaharlal Nehru is the answer. Coming to the next question, the Parliament Act of 1959 exempts several posts from disqualification on the ground of office or profit. Pata nahi hai ya nahi, right? So you might have read the whole question. Theek hai? So what is the third statement saying? The term of office of profit is well defined in the constitution. Yes. Right? So that is why I am saying there were certain questions which should not have gone wrong. Right? And the moment you arrive at the third statement, you cut all. Okay? So 1 and 2 is the answer. Under which schedule of the Constitution of India can be the transfer of tribal land to private parties for mining be declared null and void? Now this question was overthought by many. ठीक है, यार हो सकता है, ninth में भी हो सकता है, third तो is absolutely incorrect, right? So you could have eliminated third. You might have stuck in ninth, 12th भी यार मतलब it's about municipalities, right? So you should have eliminated this also. It was only ninth which was bothering, but अगेन अगर तुक्का मारना था तो फिफ्थ वॉज द मोस्ट अप्रोप्रिएट हाँ आई एम टेलिंग यू दिस वॉज अ फ्लूक पेपर यू हैव टू यू नो गिव इंटेलिजेंट गेसेस लॉजिक्स एंड देन अराइव्ड एट द आंसर ठीक है सो दैट इज ऑल नाउ एनी क्वेश्चंस विद रिस्पेक्ट टू व्हाट टू डू नाउ See, with respect to history and polity, I can say that don't go in a misguided way. Don't become a misguided missile, you know. Ki pata hi nahi hai usko kahan jana hai. Huh? Do questions reh gaye hain. Which one? Acha, Harappan site. So Harappan site is, So there were these two questions in ancient Indian history. One was, and the two were given back to back, and even Vishti wala question, right? Can you just give me a paper? Probably I'm not having it in slides, that question. So there was this back to back question on Ashoka and Harappan sites, and the two options were having Sorgoda, right? So the 97th question of this set C is, which one of the following is not a Harappan site? Chanuduro, Kotdiji are known that they are Harappan sites. Again, this was a medium to difficult question because Desalpur is not known to you and Sorgoda. But again, if you would have, probably if you would have left this question and then again went back, come next to the another question, you must have found again 100 good are given. ठीक है, तो वहाँ पर थोड़ा सा अपने आप को, you know, you should have shaken yourself कि okay, 100 good are is given in both the questions. So if you had to attempt it logically in the previous question, you should have marked 100 good are is wrong. Right? Why? Because the next question is, in which of the following relief sculpture inscriptions is Ranyo Ashoka mentioned along with the stone portrait of Ashoka? All these are Ashokan sites, edict sites. Right? Now, 100 good are, you had to believe that it is modern period and not Harappan. But again, I'm telling you, these logics would not have worked for many. And that is why this question was difficult. ठीक है, एंड आई नो मेनी ऑफ यू हैड आस्क्ड दिस दैट हाउ टू डू साइट्स, राइट? नाउ अगेन, हरप्पन, इफ दे आर आस्किंग, दे कैन गो डीप, दैट इज व्हाट दे डू. सो हरप्पन, गुप्ताज, यू नो, अशोका, दे आस्क यू डीप क्वेश्चंस. अब दिस क्वेश्चन 98, इन विच साइट और विच ऑफ द इंस्क्रिप्शंस रण्यो अशोका इज गिवन, दिस इज अ डिफिकल्ट क्वेश्चन. यू डोंट गेट दिस इन नॉर्मल बुक्स, राइट? एनसीईआरटी में भी नहीं है. यस, आई एग्री. एंड द आंसर इज कंगनहल्ली. ठीक है, आंसर इज ए टू दैट अशोका क्वेश्चन एंड आंसर इज सी टू द हरप्पन साइट. नाउ अनदर क्वेश्चन वॉज देयर विद रिस्पेक्ट टू विष्टी. नाउ विष्टी इज मेंशन्ड इन एनसीईआरटी, बट इट इज नॉट गिविंग यू दैट इट इज अ टैक्स, इट इज गिविंग यू फोर्स्ड लेबर. फोर्स्ड लेबर इज गिवन इन द question itself. Again, this was a difficult question. However, the answer is A, that it was considered a source of income for the state, a sort of tax paid by the people. ठीक है, fine. No other question left now. Any doubts? See my हाँ बोलो. Sources again, I'll say that should be standard NCERTs. NCERTs is what you should never skip, right? Don't go for optional books that is what you will get misguided with, because it has lots of information. It is a general studies paper. Even if you're not getting questions right, which they have given it difficult, it is for all, right? It is for all. You are competing amongst yourselves. Right? So if he doesn't know, you will also don't know. If she doesn't know, he will also not know. Right? The competition is always, you know, is very relative. The competition is relative. And UPSC is a classic example of it. You just cannot do things which others are not doing. Probably you can go one step beyond, but not 10 steps beyond. Right? Secondly, what I would suggest is that the approach to solve the questions has now become very, very important. That is what the lesson is you can draw from this paper. The approach to do the questions. Information nahi hogi pata. Trust me. But that is what you have to hone. That is why you again have to practice the questions. To hone those skills of doing questions. To hone those skills of applying logic. To hone those skills of eliminating. Again, you have to do that. And probably the test series or the extra information which you get, that can only sail through. So if I give you certain examples. So there was this Bhakti Sufi question. Half information is there is in NCERT, half information you get it from test series. Test series will not give you the exact question. But you get certain extra information which you cannot read it for certain, you know, subjects. And you again have to hone those skills. That is what is the solution. New NCERTs bhi karni. Yes, NCERTs is what I would say that you have to do it. Don't deviate from the basics at all. Because if you are doing it, then again the paper will become very difficult and different. They will give you only basics then. Right? So don't deviate from the basics, because again you have to have this understanding that this paper is for every person in India from every section. Right? They will not give so many questions which cannot be done by many. This paper was doable to an extent that the themes were known. But I agree that the questions which they gave, the statements which they gave, they were too deep, specifically science and tech, right? So now the other faculties will take over. That is what I can tell you with respect to history and polity. Don't deviate too much. Do your basics, do your NCRTs, but practice as much as possible different kind of questions so that you get the information, you get those skills, you get everything with respect to the approach to solve the questions, right? All the best, thanks. Yes, the cutoff, the big question. Approximately 95. Yes, for general, right? Those who are getting in the range of 90s, please start preparing for mains. Those who are getting 100 beyond, they also have to prepare for mains. Right? 90s is what you can start thinking of writing mains. 95 is the approximate cutoff, right? You don't know what will be the answer key of UPSC. One or two questions here and there, and if you've not been preparing, if you are getting score, let's say 93, you have to prepare. If you're getting a score of 92, you have to prepare. Right? So don't miss that opportunity when you will realize, okay, I wasted 1 month, because this 1 month is very costly. And this 1 month will give you an edge. Right? So don't now think of what will be the cutoff. This should not be the question. Just study. And even if someone is not getting in 90s, then also they have to, you know, prepare mains. They have to prepare optional. Theek hai? So anyways, you have to prepare mains. Right? Now you will not do it whole year or every time prelims questions practice. You have to prepare for mains. Go stage by stage. Relate that thing that you have to give mains the same month. Then only you will be preparing. Right? All the best, guys.